And now, as we wend our way back to the big city, we are on the dock of Bay State Cruises in Boston itself. We've just returned from this whirlwind week of the Provincetown Film Festival. It's all over till next year, and we're sitting here with the man who makes it all happen, the most wonderful way to get to Provincetown that I know of. It's Mike Glaspell, the owner of Bay State Cruises. Hey, Mike.
Steven, great to see you. Thanks for riding our boat. It's always a pleasure to see you every year.
Well, thank you. You know, and everybody who rides your boat just loves it. I mean, these people know how to travel. This is the way to go.
Well, we're in a lucky business. Everybody's in a good mood on board the boat. It's a fun.
Yes, they are.
It's a fun
That's
way
true.
To spend the day, fun way to travel. So thanks for joining us.
Oh, the smoothest glass in, smoothest glass out. How do you do it? You have a date with God there.
No, we control all nature, yes. Yes.
And you know more about boats than anybody I know, so tell us about, this is your boat, and that's your boat, and...
We have three of them. You were on the newest boat in the United States, the Provincetown 4.
Wow, I didn't know that.
It was delivered to us at the end of last summer, and it's the most advanced, fanciest, most expensive thing that has been built in for the passenger trade this year. And I'm happy that you could enjoy it.
Oh, it was even smoother than ever.
I'm glad you said that. We spent $1 million on something called ride control, and it's a very sophisticated piece of equipment that is always trying to keep the boat level so that you can have a comfortable ride even in the rough seas. And I'm glad it worked.
It did.
Yeah,
it did.
Great.
And that's your boat too over there?
This is the old girl, the Provincetown 2. So we have the Provincetown 2, 3, and 4. We're not very imaginative, but we love paying homage to the town that we all love so much. The Provincetown 2 holds 1,100 people. Back in the day, she was a fast ferry at 16 knots, but not so fast anymore. Now we have these things going twice as fast.
And it's a harbor. It's a long cruise. It's a different ride, isn't it? Or they're all fast?
No, we have two high-speed ferries. The Provincetown 2 that Stephen's referring to my left here, is. It only goes to Provincetown now on the weekends. People have decided they want to get there only fast, except for the weekends, then they'll go the slower way. It's about a three-hour ride on the slow boat, hour and a half on the high-speed boat.
And what is the difference? You go to different...
It's just traveling slower. Just traveling slower. And we have a whole cadre of people that really enjoy that. They say for them, being on the water is what they enjoy. So
they find
it a great value to be on the water. They say to me, in fact, that I should charge more to be on the slower boat because they get to enjoy the water more. I wish that was so. But
It's a ride I never want to end when I'm on.
Well, I'm glad to hear you say that. I love mixing it up. I love going down on the slower boat and then coming back in the fast boat. It's a lot of fun. That boat was famous for coining the term steel beach because it has steel decks. Back in the late 70s and early 80s, you would see all the handsome young gentlemen on their bathing blankets, beach blankets, out on the top deck sunning themselves. It's just a fabulous tradition. It goes back decades.
And where are these boats built? I mean, are they here in Massachusetts?
Well, we are extraordinarily fortunate. Not only do we have this great town of Provincetown here in the Commonwealth of Massachusetts, we also have the foremost builder of high-speed ferries in Massachusetts as well.
So it's
Somerset, Massachusetts, down near the famous town of Fall River.
Yes, that I know. I went to that house.
Yeah.
The Lizzie Borden house.
There you go. That's right. And it's a community steeped in maritime tradition, as is all of the Commonwealth. And so we're very fortunate to have the vessels built there.
And do you run the boats all year long, or...?
We do, but not here. The seas get relatively treacherous up here in the wintertime.
I
could sell a ticket, but it would be more akin to a thrill ride than a pleasure ride. So what we do is we send one of our high-speed ferries down to the Caribbean.
I knew there was a story about tropical islands. So
yes.
Waiting to be told.
Yes.
I knew it.
Nothing piratical, mind you, but it's still lovely. We go down to the British Virgin Islands, and we run a route between
fabulous.
The BVI and the USV. And we love them when our Provincetown customers come down and see us there. It's just a hoot.
We'll have to do that next, obviously.
Next on our agenda, Steve, and let's count on it.
The British
Virgin Islands?
I'm calling them when I get back to New York.
I would love to have you down there. It would be just a hoot. We'll do this all over again with a beautiful volcanic outcrop behind us, okay?
Oh, that would be something. And I always have to give a shout out to the lovely lady who assists you and me getting here. Julie Daugherty is not here again today. But
Julie, our general manager, is really the grand dame of vessels in Boston Harbor. Her family's been running boats in Boston Harbor for over 75 years.
I did not know that.
Yeah, no, it's really remarkable. Her grandfather started a business here in town that really paved the way for all the passenger boat industry. And she's just a treasure, just great. And she loves the Provincetown Ferry. We all love what we do. We're very fortunate. We do what we love what we do, and life is good.
And it keeps everyone young and vital, and you know, and we were talking of the last time we got to speak, and without a camera, but which I should never open my mouth without a camera filming me, a note to future, but I was telling you about my great-grandfather, who was a sea captain, Gottfried Frankfurt from Hamburg, Germany. You can all say that along with me. You've memorized it at this point. And you figured out something about why I never get seasick.
Well, yeah, often.
And I think you're right.
Yeah, perhaps it was
about
the inner ear. Some of us are blessed with an inner ear that can handle the disconnect between what our eyes are seeing and what our brain is feeling, and some can't. and that's really the origin of motion sickness, is that disconnect between the eyes and the inner ear moving. And because of your grandfather, you say?
Great-grandfather,
then
out of Hamburg, yeah.
You are seasick proof, and you're a blessed soul. It's good.
Do you get seasick? Or?
If it gets bad enough, I'll get it, okay. Sure enough. I don't think it's a matter of if for most people. It's a matter of when.
Oh, okay. I'm born to be on the ocean.
Well, and
born to be nautical.
And to put the positive spin on all of it, we're very fortunate that we have placid waters here in the summertime when we trade.
I've never had a bad trip ever.
And now with our fancy ride control and the high-speed ferry, it's almost always a smooth ride.
And look at the sunshine.
Glorious.
The air.
Glorious. We're in the 28th hour of summer now, and it's all that it promised to be.
Right.
Just wonderful.
It's the first day of summer. Everything's just starting, and we're sort of almost winding up here because we're on our way back to New York now, but I know I'll see you again next year. I hope I do.
We look forward to it.
And maybe we can do something, you know, on the boat or chat or show more.
We'll have you on the helm. You know, I think you got to blow the whistle. You got to drive. It's all part of the experience. You've graduated to that now.
Well, just the idea of that image is making me laugh.
We'll look forward to it.
Okay, thank you so
much.
Thank
you, Stephen.
Mike Glaspell here at On the Dock in Boston of Bay State Cruises, the best way to go back and forth to Provincetown. Thank you, Mike.
Thank you.